Thanks so much for watching Ebru News Live. I'm Francesca Maxime. Here's a look at the top stories making headlines all around the world.
And we are now going to look at math with the map to see what it looks like overseas with the international outlook.
My cat might like that toy too. Little too expensive though. If you've ever gotten one of those calls, I think you know just how rough those people can be on the other end of the phone. We love our newspapers here, and so we're going to take a look at what is making news across America. Mia is over at Live Touch with what's going on today. Hi, Mia.
Go West.
I got some more big news for you. And this one is about Pennsylvania.
Canada firefighters spent close to a full day battling a large blaze that was sparked at a fuel plant. You know, here in New York, it has been a soupy,
very
last few days.
With the fall colors, people are out enjoying all the scenery. And Matt, you know, you get a chance to enjoy the fall foliage, right, this weekend?
I did.
How would you know?
That is an excellent question. I don't have a great answer for that one.
I ask the tough questions here on Every
well,
Today.
Just like getting
straight to Turkey and the Syrian conflict there and its spillover into Turkey.
Thanks to Google Script, the whole New York City neighborhood of Chelsea will get it all for free, all 7,000 residents.
That ole, ole, ole song.
Yeah, that's victory in any language. And not for the U.S., unfortunately. From the China Daily, that's where we're going to start. Take a look at this great picture. Get your popcorn and watch that one.
The president and his Republican challenger, Mitt Romney, they are getting ready to fight it out in a big debate that some say could decide it all. Their first debate on October 3rd. It's the first time America and the whole world will get to see the two men square off. Ebru's Kyle Schmoyer explores what the two are preparing for the big night. The North Korean vice foreign minister also blasted the UN about the Syrian conflict. He says the unjustifiable interference, pressure, and use of force that violates the sovereignty and territorial integrity of Syria and the right to self-determination and existence of Palestine should be rejected. That's a quote from Pak Kil-yeon. He also lashed out at the United States, saying that repeated U.S. military exercises near the Korean Peninsula is, quote, proof of aggression. Take a look at this great picture over here at the China Daily. It is all flowers. This is all to celebrate. Here we go. You can see that. This is all to celebrate the People's Republic of China's 63rd birthday, known as China's National Day. The flowers in this photo are here as soldiers lay baskets on the monument to the people's heroes in Tiananmen Square, and that is in Beijing. You can see them there taking those flowers over. And this floral display is the most elaborate ever and includes built-in lighting effects for nighttime display as well. Over 50 species of flowers are all on display, and to stay fresh, they have special irrigation with a needle delivering water right to the roots over here. So quite a picture there, so colorful. All right, and we are heading over to Greece right now. We are going to Canada. Firefighters spent close to a full day battling a large blaze that was sparked at a fuel plant. Thick black smoke and flames rose from a warehouse in Winnipeg after a huge fire broke out in the afternoon. Throughout the evening, explosions could be seen as the contents of the warehouse caught on fire. Look at those pictures. The warehouse holds highly explosive fuel for racing cars and had about 17,000 gallons of methanol and biofuel on site. People who live in the area were told that the danger from the fumes was minimal, however, because the fuel is so-called clean burning. However, many homes were evacuated because of the continued danger of explosions. There were no injuries, and it is still not known what started that fire. We love our newspapers here, and so we're going to take a look at what is making news across America. Mia is over at Live Touch with what's going on today. Hi, Mia. You ever said, ouch, my aching back? Well, yeah, many of us do have one, or pains in our necks, and we seek relief in various ways. Could be a massage, maybe an anti-inflammatory, or it could be in the form of a chiropractor. But many people are sort of split on the issue as to whether or not they're effective or whether or not they're the right thing for you. So to describe his profession and tell us what happens when we go in for chiropractic treatment is Dr. Kent Mehmet Osman. He joins us now with more. Hi, Dr. Kent, and welcome to our program, Ebru Today.
It's good to be back. I've been on Ebru back in 07 twice on the then morning show, and they did a 60-minute segment on me as well. It's a wonderful show you have here. Welcome to America, Canada, Africa, and now Europe. Oh my goodness, you guys are getting really big.
All around the world. So Dr. Kent, for people who don't know, tell us what you do. You're a chiropractor.
I'm a chiropractor, and I've been doing it for 18 years.
Okay, so is that how it then differs from the quote-unquote regular medical model, chiropractic medicine, as opposed to what we normally considered, you know, what you would just do if you were going to your regular internist?
Well, if you want to consider
it gets to be a little too late.
Okay, so that's sort of the whole idea of actually going in for wellness treatment, not just going in when you have a pain in your neck or a pain in your back. And talk to me
me about the different things that people can do and what they should expect if they go in and they're seeking wellness.
Well, very good cards. Some that are as soft as a touch, some that use an electrical gun, all sorts of different styles.
How do you determine which one you might be best suited for? What kind of personality you have, or what kind of body type you have, or what your affliction is? How would you know?
That is an excellent question. I don't have a great answer for that one.
I ask the tough questions here on Every
well,
Today.
Just like getting your car fixed, what do you do?
Gotcha. You brought a little friend along. Do we get a chance to check him out?
Well, I call him Cal Seam, from a doctor friend of mine who named hers that.
Okay.
So, but the point of
I get it now. Sorry. Don't. Took me a minute.
But the point of this is that the nervous system comes from above.
Sure.
What's the first thing you say? Check the switch.
Check the switch. Like you said, is it plugged in? Yeah, the knee bone is connected to the thigh bone. The hip bone could be connected to the neck bone.
Right.
So is there anybody for whom this is more suited? You know, can kids do it? Adults? People that have had injuries? Is it?
Well, let's go back to medical model.
Okay.
Would you say, I'll take my child to the dentist as soon as he turns 21.
No. I hope not. That would be bad.
Chiropractic pediatrics, more fix it.
All right. That's good to know. We can fix it and we can prevent it. Thank you, Dr. Kent, for joining us on Ebru Today. I love the display here. I like the show and tell.
And next time we're going to show and demonstrate how we do these things. Thank you.
I don't know if I'm going to be the guinea pig that time, but you know, we'll find another one.
Very good.
Thanks, Dr. Kent.
You're welcome.
All righty. Well, Matt Locker may or may not need a chiropractor. I'm not quite so sure, but he's here with a look at the national weather and see if that needs a little tweaking or not. I don't know. What's the word, Matt?
We're going to head on over to Francesca Maxime to find out what's happening all over the United States from east to the west.
I got some more big news for you.
Good.
And this one is about Pennsylvania, and it looks like President Barack Obama. Well, actually, this one isn't showing it right now, but it does look like he took Pennsylvania. And that was a big state that Mitt Romney was trying to get at, but doesn't look like it happened. However, we're going to come back with the official AP call on that, but we think that that's where it's going. Anyway, we're going to bounce over to some Senate races right now, and we're going to talk a little bit about the fact that over here, these yellow states, this is independents. This is not Republicans, not Democrats. This is the third party candidate. Over in Maine, Logan Crawford's home state, our illustrious anchor, Angus King. You can call him the king of the hill, the king of the crop, the king of Maine, Logan, because Angus King is come out on top over here in Maine. This is the AP's official call, and he's not alone in his race to independence, if you will. Over in Vermont, also, you also have another independent, Bernie Sanders, who won re-election there. So that was with 71%. We also have some races that are also being called right now: Rhode Island, Maryland, Delaware, and Tennessee. So let's start with Rhode Island. We have over here Sheldon Whitehouse, the Democratic Senator from Rhode Island. He's taken that. We're going to go to Maryland right now, and over here, of course, you know, I have to figure out my geography. There we go. Again, Ben Cardin, the Democrat, these are states in the Northeastern Corridor, often do go Democratic. Ben Cardin with 63% of the vote there. AP has called that. So, of course, the balance of power in the Senate is what's at stake here. We know that it has obviously been in the hands of the Democrats. The House has been in the hands of the Republicans. It looks as though right now, with 42 seats, still Democrat, and 41 of them Republican, it's neck and neck again. The independents, just one seat right there. So we're going to see what happens, whether or not Democrats retain control of the Senate. Likely that they will, just like it's likely that the House will retain, that the Republicans will, you know, maintain control of the House. But we have to check out these other races that are going to go down to the wire and see where they lead us. Logan and Nicole.
Thanks so much for watching Ebru News Live. I'm Francesca Maxime. Here's a look at the top stories making headlines all around the world at this hour. Well, in the United States, an increase in flu cases has prompted some cities to declare a state of emergency. Health officials say there are more cases than usual, and they have started earlier than usual.
The number of people suffering from the flu in the U.S. is almost 10 times higher than last year in some cities. In Boston, the city has declared a public health emergency and will begin offering free flu vaccinations. Health authorities said flu season usually starts in December, but began in November this year. The particular flu strain going around, H3N2, has a reputation for causing fairly severe illness, especially among the elderly. Hospitals around the country are running out of space, and some have had to turn people away. The U.S. Center for Disease Control recommends that everyone over the age of 6 months get a flu shot.
Well, in New York City, a crane has collapsed onto a building under construction near the East River waterfront, injuring 7 people, 3 of whom needed to be rescued from underneath the fallen machinery. The red crane toppled around 2:30 p.m. local time Wednesday, sprawling across the metal scaffolding and wood planking that made up the first floor skeleton of a residential building in Queens. Workers putting up the second floor framework scrambled to get out of the way. The people who had to be extricated from underneath the crane suffered a range of injuries, including broken bones being the most severe. None of the injuries, however, was life-threatening. Well, after the Newtown School massacre, President Barack Obama promised to tackle gun control with concrete proposals by the end of January. Now, Vice President Joe Biden, in charge of that process, says the president means business and isn't backing down. Well, President Obama continues to make changes to his cabinet. Timothy Geithner will no longer serve as the Treasury Secretary in the White House. Chief of Staff to Obama, Jack Lew, is expected to be the lead pick for the Treasury Department head role. An announcement is expected by the end of the week. White House officials have yet to confirm the move, but aides didn't dispute Liu as the consensus choice. To North Korea now, Google Executive Chairman Eric Schmidt urged North Korea to shed its self-imposed isolation and allow its citizens to use the internet or risk staying behind economically after seeing the tightly controlled country on a private visit.
Once the internet starts.
Thank you.
Well, Schmidt joined former New Mexico Governor Bill Richardson, that you saw pictured next to him there, in a delegation that also urged North Korea to put a moratorium on missile launches and nuclear tests that had prompted UN sanctions and sought fair treatment for a detained American citizen there. Tablet computers, they are ruling the roost at the Consumer Electronics Show in Las Vegas. From special gaming tablets to apps that can control toys, the mini computer is making great strides.
There's a new
kid. My cats love this toy, so.
My cat might like that toy too. A little too expensive though. All right, Los Angeles's Nokia Theater played host to the 39th annual People's Choice Awards last night, and the biggest winner of the night was the film and the cast of The Hunger Games.
Hunger Games.
People's Choice to Oscar time. If you love the movies, listen up. The Civil War saga Lincoln leads the Academy Award nominations for Best Picture, 12 nominations, Director for Steven Spielberg, acting honors for Daniel Day-Lewis, Sally Field, and Tommy Lee Jones.
For Best Original Screenplay.
Just over a month away. That's always a fun time. Get your popcorn and watch that one. All right, thanks so much for watching this edition of Ebru News Live. I'm Francesca Maxime. Please stay tuned to Ebru News for all the latest headlines. Have a great day.